Good morning, children. How are you? This is R. Sujana, your English teacher. Today, we are going to study an interesting lesson.
Okay, ma.
All of you, see this picture. What do you find in this picture? Yes, few boys and girls, they are wearing uniforms. And they are carrying lunch bags and school bags. And they are talking themselves and they are looking very happy. And they are going to school. And one girl, she is sitting in the veranda of a house and she is weaving cane baskets. Okay, what do you observe in this picture? What they are talking, one girl, she is saying, I am so happy to meet you. One boy is saying, more play in school. One girl is saying, we can share and learn new things. What they are talking about? They are talking about the benefits of going to school. One girl is saying, we can share and learn new things. Why are you coming to school? For just playing? Nona, you can play here as well as you can share and learn new things. So kids, they love to come to school. Okay, ma? All of you, observe this picture carefully. Here, the girl, she is on the bed. Her name is Mallika. She is looking so happy today. Okay, ma? I will read the paragraph. All of you, keep your pencil ready with you. Okay? When I say to underline the words, you be ready with your pencil. Okay? Today is a very special day for Mallika. The name of the girl is Mallika. She was so excited that she could not sleep after dawn. Underline the word dawn. What do you mean by dawn? Early morning before sunrise. That means if you get up early morning before the sun rises, that is called dawn. So Mallika, she got up very early that day before the sunrise. She eagerly looked out of the window. The newly paved road seemed to be welcoming her. Ma, all of you underline the word eagerly. Eagerly means what? Showing a lot of interest. She is eagerly looking out of the window. The newly paved road seemed to be welcoming her. Very recently, they have got a new road. This is the day Mallika has been waiting for. Do you know why? It is neither a festival nor her birthday. Today is going to be Mallika's first day at school. The school is not far away from her home, but she has to come down the main road from the hill to reach there. Actually, Mallika, she is not going to the school. Even though the school is very nearer to our home, she is not going to school. Why she is not going to school? We will come to know that thing later. That day, Mallika is very eager. She is waiting for that day. It is not her birthday. It is not a festival. That day, she is going to school for the first time in her life. Her family resides on the foothills of Nallamala Forest. The way to the school is narrow, rocky, and uneven. Her little brother, Nandu, walks down the rocky path to school along with other children of the neighborhood. but Mallika could not, as she was differently abled. Where does Mallika's family reside? Where do they live? Her family resides on the foothills of Nallamala forest. The way to the school is very narrow, rocky and uneven. So the road, the way to the school from her home is very narrow and it's full of rocks and it is uneven. So it is very difficult to walk on that kind of route. No? Her little brother Nandu walks down the rocky path to school along with other children of the neighborhood. What is her brother's name? Nandu. Nandu, every day he goes on that rocky path to reach the school. He goes along with other children of his neighborhood. But Mallika could not, as she was differently abled. It is so sad. Mallika is not going to school because she is having some physically handicapped. She is differently abled. My dear children, you are not having this kind of problems in your life. You are all happily coming to the school in vans. Okay. So Mallika, she does not have that kind of facilities for her. Okay. Okay, ma. All of you see this picture. Who are there in the picture? Yeah, in this picture you can see Mallika's father, Mallika's mother, Mallika and her brother Nandu. Mallika, she is sitting on a wheelchair. Okay, let's see the next paragraph. Right from her childhood, Mallika could not walk. As she was growing older, she found that she could not do things like other children. Don't worry, you can weave a variety of cane baskets faster than anyone else. Mallika, she has not gone to the school since from her childhood because she is differently able, na? She is not able to walk. That's why she is so unhappy and disappointed. As she was growing older, na, she found that she could not do things like other children. So her father, he used to console her. My dear child, don't worry. You can weave a variety of cane baskets faster than anyone else. You have seen pictures of cane baskets in the previous pictures, na? So she can do the cane baskets. You can paint beautiful pictures. So Mallika is having the very good skill of painting beautiful pictures, and she can do she can weave the cane baskets very faster than anyone else. She has that magic in her hands. Her Nana always consoled her. Nana means who here? Nana means her father, Mallika's and Nandu's father. There was a celebration when Amma bought a wheelchair home. One day it was a happy occasion at their home because Mallika's mother, she brought a wheelchair. Everyone in the family was excited that Mallika could wheel at least around the house. So everybody thought that at least Mallika, she can go around her home using that wheelchair because she is not able to walk, na? Okay. Ma, all of you underline the word consoled. What is the meaning of console? To comfort someone at the time of grief. Sometimes in our life also we cry for any reason. If you, your brother and sister, if they are weeping, what do? You will beat them? No, na? You go to your brother or sister and you try to console them so that they will stop crying. So here Mallika's father used to console Mallika. Okay, one morning while Mallika was painting the scene of the sunrise, Ranga, her neighbor, came to her. He was astonished to see her skill in painting. "Would you like to come to school?" he asked. One morning, what happened? Ranga, Mallika's neighbor, Ranga came to Mallika's home. When he came, that time Mallika was painting the scene of sunrise. It was so beautiful. He was astonished to see her skill in painting. Amma, all of you underline the word astonished. Astonished means more surprised. Ranga is so surprised to see that picture. He asked her, "Would you like to come to school, Mallika?" He asked Mallika, "Do you want to come to school?" Mallika replied, "I have never been to school. The path to the school is too uneven and rocky for me to get down. Moreover, Nana cannot carry me all the way to Mallika every day," replied Mallika sadly. What did Mallika say? Mallika said, "Ranga, I cannot go to the school every day because that path to the school is very uneven and it's full of rocks. Even Nana cannot carry me all the way to school every day because her father, he is having his own work, he has to go for his work. So how come he be all the time with Mallika? It is very impossible for her father to be with her all the time. But would you like to come to school if possible?" he insisted. Ranga asked her, "If it is possible, do you want to come to our school?" All of you underline the word insisted. What is the meaning of insisted? Demanded continuously. Ranga is, he wanted Mallika to be at the school. He wanted Mallika to study at the school. So that's why he keep on asking, "Will you come to school? Will you come to school?" like that. Then Mallika said, "Of course, I dream to go to school like everyone else. I too want to make friends, play games, wear a uniform and learn new things." Tears rolled down from her eyes as she spoke. Mallika said, "Yes, Ranga, I want to go to school. I want to study in school. I want to make friends. I want to play games. I want to wear uniform and learn new things." Tears rolled down from her eyes as she spoke means she started weeping. So sad, So she wanted to go to school. We are all having the opportunity of coming to school. So, Mallika, she is not having that facility because of her inability to walk. And second thing, the way to the school is very rocky and uneven. Okay, my dear children, you are not having that kind of problems, So be regular to school and study well. Okay, ma'am? All of you see this picture. What do you observe in this picture? Who is that boy? He is none other than Ranga, Mallika's neighbor. He went to meet his headmaster at the school. Ranga consoled her and went straight to meet the school headmaster. Explaining Mallika's situation, he said, she uses a wheelchair to move around but cannot reach school. I wish if we could all get together and level the path for Mallika. Ranga, he went to the school and he met his headmaster and he explained the situation of Mallika. And he said, "Sir, Mallika uses a wheelchair to move around, but she cannot reach the school because the way is rocky and uneven. Na? If we can level the path for Mallika, she is able to come to school. Then the headmaster said, yeah, that's a very good idea, Ranga. Children have the right to get education, includes Mallika as well, said the headmaster, patting him on the back. Ranga's headmaster is very caring and helpful. He said, yes, Ranga, children, they should have the right to get education. Even Mallika, she has the right to study. But the thing is, we have to help her. So, sir, he patted him on the back. Ma, all of you underline the word patting. Patting. Patting means tapping with hand in appreciation. Ranga's headmaster is so happy about Ranga because of his helping nature. The next day, he assembled the parents' committee and discussed the same. They made a plan so that Mallika could bring her wheelchair to school. For this, the uneven road had to be leveled. So the next day, headmaster sir, he gathered parents' committee and discussed the situation of Mallika. They made a plan so that Mallika can come to the school. But how? So for this thing, the uneven road has to be leveled. How come it is going to be leveled? They have got a plan in their mind. Yeah. 2 days later, there was a great excitement at the school. It was Saturday, a no bad day. The teachers along with the students picked up all the stones and pulled out all the weeds using spades and hoes. The village panchayat contributed by laying a good road. Everyone wanted Mallika to come to school. Okay? After 2 days, there was a great excitement at the school. Why? Because it was Saturday. All of us, we love Saturday because the next day is Sunday, na? We are going to have a holiday. And why these children are so happy? The Saturday, we used to have no bad day, na? So they are very happy. The teachers and students, they went to that uneven path and they picked up all the stones and pulled out all the weeds using spades and hoes. Okay, ma, all of you underline the word weeds. What do you mean by weeds? Weeds means unwanted plants. Okay, they have removed the weeds and unwanted plants using spades and hoes. Okay, ma, what do you mean by spades and hoes? So now all of you see the picture of spade. This spade is used for removing trash or soil, digging canals or ditches and mixing soil. Okay, and next see the picture of hoe. It is used for breaking hard top soil and pulverizing. Means it's a long handled tool with a narrow blade. These spades and hoes, they are normally used as tools in gardening or farming. Okay, so all the people of that village, they removed all the weeds using spades and hoes, and the village panchayat contributed by laying a good road. So now a good road has been made in that village from Mallika's home to school. Everyone wanted Mallika to come to school. It means that all the villagers are very good. They are having helping nature. So they all wanted to, Mallika to come to school. See this picture, this is very beautiful, na? So here all the villagers are helping each other. Here Mallika is sitting in the wheelchair and the if you see the road it is very good na. So here Mallika's mother and father, they are very happy because their daughter is going to school from that day. Her mother, she prepared. All the children were happy, but the happiest of all was Mallika. She gave the headmaster a bouquet. You can see the picture of bouquet. It's a collection of flowers. So she is giving flowers to her headmaster. Her parents thanked everyone with ragi laddus. Mallika's mother, she prepared ragi laddus, so they thanked everyone and they gave ragi laddus to everyone. The path to the school is now ready. I never dreamt I would see a day like this. Mallika wiped her tears in excitement. Okay, ma? So, Mallika, she is so happy and tears are rolling down from her eyes. She is in excitement. She never dreamt that she could see that kind of day. So, now Mallika, she can go to school. All of you, underline the word bouquet, bouquet. What is the meaning of bouquet? Bunch of flowers. Underline the word wiped. Wiped means removed. Now the road is good. Mallika can go to school. So the name of the lesson is Mallika Goes to School. It's a lovely story, na? So it came to an end. It was a happy ending, okay? All of you, see the glossary once, ma? I say the words, you also say the words. Dawn, early morning before sunrise. Eagerly, showing a lot of interest. Uneven, not even, not flat, unlevel. Console, to comfort someone at the time of grief. Astonished, more surprised, insisted, demanded continuously. Patting, tapping with hand in appreciation. Weeds, unwanted plants. Bouquet, a bunch of flowers. Wiped, removed. Okay, that's all for today. Today you have to read this lesson at your home. By tomorrow morning, be thorough with the glossary words, learn the spellings and meanings. Okay, thank you. Bye.